Good afternoon, and welcome to Saints Peter and Paul. In a special way, we would like of God's love and mercy for you. This weekend, we celebrate Palm Sunday of the Lord's of Holy Week. And so let us stand together and pray the prayer to the Holy Spirit, may the same fire of love in the heart of Jesus and the heart of Mary inflame our hearts so that through prayer and boldness in word and ministry, everyone in our parish and our local community will encounter Jesus, grow in faith, and witness the faith in word and deed. Amen. Forth your spirit, and they shall be created, and you shall renew the face of the earth. O God, who did instruct the hearts of the faithful by the light of the Holy Spirit, grant that by the same Holy Spirit we may be truly wise and ever enjoy his consolations. Through the same Christ our Lord. Amen. Reading, opening hymn for the procession can be found on the worship aids at the entrances to the church and in the gathering space.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My brothers and sisters, since the beginning of Lent until now, we have prepared our hearts by penance and charitable works. Today we gather together to herald with the whole church the beginning of the celebration of our Lord's Paschal mystery, that is to say, of his passion and resurrection. For it was to accomplish this mystery that he entered his own city of Jerusalem. Therefore, with all faith and devotion, let us commemorate the Lord's entry into the city for our salvation, following in his footsteps, so that being made by his grace partakers of the cross, we may have a share also in his resurrection. Increase the faith of those who place their hope in you, O God, and hear the prayers of those who call on you, so that we may tie these branches to hail Christ in his triumph, may bear fruit for you by good works accomplished in him, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, O Lord.
When Jesus and his disciples drew near Jerusalem to Bethphage and Bethany at the Mount of Olives, he sent two of his disciples and said to them, "Go into the village opposite you, and immediately on entering it, you will find a colt tethered on which no one ever sat. Untie it and bring it. Should say to you, 'Why are you doing this?' Reply, 'The master has need of it, and will bring it back, send it back here at once.' So they went off and found the colt tethered at a gate outside of the street, and they untied it. Some of the bystanders said to them, 'What are you doing, untying the colt?' They answered them just as Jesus had told them to, and they permitted them to do it. So they brought it to the colt to Jesus, and he put their cloaks over it, and he sat on it. Cloaks on the road, and others spread leafy branches, and they had to cut that they had cut from the fields. Those preceded him, as well as those following, kept crying out, 'Hosanna! Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Blessed is the kingdom of our father David that is to come. Hosanna in the highest.'" The Gospel of
Praise to you, Lord
Jesus
Christ.
As the crowds are shouting out Hosanna, they're shouting out Hosanna to the Son of David, the Messiah, the one that everyone has looked for. That is why we call Jesus the Christ, the Messiah, the Anointed One. And the Messiah was supposed to do three things. He was supposed to be a priest, prophet, and king. And as Jesus comes into Jerusalem, he overturns the temple worship. He casts out all the money changers and those with animals in the temple. And he restores right worship, not of the law, but of the heart. And the crowd scream out, "Hosanna." He is indeed the Word made flesh. He is, his words are to the ends of the earth. The words are written down so that we, even here, 2,000 years later, are saying what he has said and reliving his teaching. And so the crowds as well says, "Hosanna in the highest." called to be a king, and he expresses his kingly rule by casting out demons, curing the sick, curing lepers, raising the dead. And one would say, Hosanna, but instead, he is not promising to kick out the Romans. And because of that, we'll shout, crucify him, crucify him. Oftentimes, we can, if we don't get exactly what we want, when we want, to throw the gifts of God back into his face and reject it. Certainly, no one would have thought that a crucified man would be the ultimate gift to us of our salvation. And many people then deny the cross or walk away or say, you're crazy to be worshiping a man crucified on the cross 2,000 years ago. But we accept the gift that God has given us. And indeed, we accept the other gifts God has given us. Whenever we say, well, my health isn't exactly as great as it used to be, even though we can do many things, we reject the gift of God. When our spouse or our relationships aren't exactly the way we want it to go, we can focus on the negative and reject the gift of God. When our life, whatever our envisions for life, doesn't turn out exactly the way we want, how we want, and everything else, we can shout out, crucify him. Is when we embrace the cross that we actually accept the gift God has given us. And when we accept that gift, we see the blessings that we have been given in our lives, and therefore we're now able to say thanks and worship him at his table. And so as we go forth into this, beginning this Holy Week, it is our obligation to see the gift God has given us in the crucified Savior and in our own lives. And so my brothers and sisters, like the crowds who claimed Jesus in Jerusalem, let us go forth in peace.
Oh, Almighty ever-living God, as an example of humility for the human race to follow, you caused our Savior to take flesh and submit to the cross. Grant that we may hear who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. The Lord God has given me a well-trained tongue, that I might know how to speak a word that will rouse them. Morning after morning, have not turned back. I gave my back to those who beat me, my cheeks to those who plucked my beard. My face I did not shield from buffets and spitting. Lord God is my help. Therefore I am not disgraced. I have set my face like flint, knowing that I shall not be put to shame. The word of the Lord.
from the letter of St. Paul to the Christ Jesus, though he was in the form of God, did not regard equality with God something to be grasped. Rather, he emptied himself, taking the form of a slave, coming in human likeness, and found human in appearance. He humbled himself, become obedient to the point of death, and death on a cross. Because of this, and bestowed on him the name, every name, that at the name of Jesus he should bend of those in heaven and on earth and under the earth, and every tongue confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Passion of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Mark.
If you need to be seated, please do so, because the Passion is of a longer nature.
The Passover and the Feast of Unleavened Bread were to take place in 2 days' time. So the chief priest and the scribes were seeking a way to arrest him by treachery and put him to death. They said, when he was in Bethany reclining at table in the house of Simon the leper, a woman came with an alabaster jar of perfumed oil, costly, genuine spikenard. She broke the alabaster jar and poured it on his head. There were some who,
why has there been this waste of perfumed oil? It could have been sold for more than 300 days' wages and the money given to the poor.
They were infuriated with her. Jesus said,
let her alone. Why do you make trouble for her? She has done a good thing for me. The poor you will always have with you, and whenever you wish, you can do good to them. But you will not always have me. She has done what she could. She has anticipated anointing my body for burial. Amen, I say to you, whenever the gospel is proclaimed to the whole world, what she has done will be told in memory of her.
Then Judas Iscariot, one of the 12, went off to the chief priests to hand him over to them. When they heard him, they were pleased and promised to pay him money. Then he looked for an opportunity to hand him over. On the first day of the Feast of Unleavened Bread, when they sacrificed the Passover lamb, his disciples said to him,
where do you want us to go and prepare for you to eat the Passover?
He sent two of his disciples and said to them,
"Go into the city, and a man will meet you carrying a jar of water. Follow him. Wherever he enters, say to the master of the house, 'The teacher says, where is my guest room where I may eat the Passover with my disciples?' Then he will show you a large upper room furnished and ready. Make the preparations for us there."
The disciples went off, entered the city, and found it just as he had told them, and they prepared the Passover. When it was evening, he came with the 12, and as they reclined at table and were eating, Jesus said,
"Amen, I say to you, one of you will betray me, one who is eating with me."
They began to be distressed and say to one another, to him, one by one,
"Surely it is not I, Lord."
He said to them,
"One of the 12, the one who dips with me into the dish. For the Son of Man indeed goes, as it is written of him. But woe to that man by whom the Son of Man is betrayed. It would be better for that man if he had never been born."
While they were eating, he took bread, said the blessing, broke it, and gave it to them, and said,
"Take it, this is my body."
Then he took a cup, gave thanks, and gave it to them, and they all drank from it. He said to them,
"This is my blood of the covenant, which will be shed for many. Amen, I say to you, I shall not drink again the fruit of the vine until the day when I drink it new in the kingdom of God."
Then, after singing a hymn, they went out to the Mount of Olives. Jesus said to them,
"All of you will have your faith shaken, for it is written, 'I will strike the shepherd, and the sheep will be dispersed.' But after I have been raised up, I shall go before you to Galilee."
Peter said to him,
"Even though all should have their faith shaken, mine will not be."
Then Jesus said to him,
"Amen, I say to you, this very night, before the cock crows twice, you will deny me three times."
But he vehemently replied,
"Even though I should have to die with you, I will not deny you."
And they all spoke similarly. Then they came to a place named Gethsemane, and he said to his disciples,
"Sit here while I pray."
He took with him Peter, James, and John, and began to be troubled and distressed. He said to them,
"My soul is sorrowful, even to death. Remain here and keep watch."
He advanced a little and fell to the ground and prayed that if it were possible, the hour might pass by him. He said,
"Abba, Father, all things are possible to you. Take this cup away from me, but not what I will, but what you will."
When he returned, he found them asleep. He said to Peter,
"Simon, are you asleep? Could you not keep watch for 1 hour? Watch and pray that you may not undergo the test. The spirit is willing, but the flesh is weak."
Withdrawing again, he prayed, saying the same thing. Then he returned once more and found them asleep, for they could not keep their eyes open and did not know what to answer him. He returned a third time and said to them,
"Are you still sleeping and taking your rest? It is enough. The hour has come. Behold, the Son of Man is to be handed over to sinners. Get up, let us go. See, my betrayer is at hand."
Then, while he was still speaking, Judas, one of the 12, arrived, accompanied by a crowd with swords and clubs, who had come from the chief priests, the scribes, and the elders. His betrayer had arranged a signal with them, saying,
"The man I shall kiss is the one. Arrest him and lead him away securely."
He came and immediately went over to him and said,
"Rabbi."
And he kissed him. At this they laid hands on him and arrested him. One of the bystanders drew a sword, struck the high priest's servant, and cut off his ear. Jesus said to them in reply,
"Have you come out as against a robber, with swords and clubs to seize me? Day after day I was with you, teaching in the temple area, yet you did not arrest me, but that the scriptures may be fulfilled.
And they all left him and fled. Now a young man followed him, wearing nothing but a linen cloth about his body. They seized him, but he left the cloth behind and ran off naked. Then they led Jesus away to the high priest, and all the chief priests and the elders and the scribes came together. Peter followed him at a distance into the high priest's courtyard and was seated with the guards, warming himself at the fire. The chief priests and the entire Sanhedrin kept trying to obtain testimony against Jesus in order to put him to death, but they found none. Many gave false witness against him, but their testimony did not agree. Some took the stand and testified falsely against him, alleging,
"We heard him say, 'I will destroy this temple made with hands, and within 3 days I will build another, not made with hands.'"
Even so, their testimony did not agree. The high priest rose before the assembly and questioned Jesus, saying,
"Have you no answer? What are these men testifying against you?"
But he was silent and answered nothing. Again, the high priest asked him and said to him,
"Are you the Christ, the Son of the Blessed One?"
Then Jesus answered,
"I am. And you will see the Son of Man seated at the right hand of the power and coming with the clouds of heaven."
At that, the high priest tore his garments and said,
"What further need have we of witnesses? You have heard the blasphemy. What do you think?"
They all condemned him as deserving to die. Some began to spit on him. They blindfolded him and struck him and said to him,
"Prophesy."
And the guards greeted him with blows. While Peter was below in the courtyard, one of the high priest's maids came along. Seeing Peter warming himself, she looked intently at him and said, but he denied it, saying,
"I neither know nor understand what you are talking about."
So he went out into the outer court. Then the cock crowed. The maid saw him and began again to say to the bystanders,
"This man is one of them."
Once again, he denied it. A little later, the bystander said to Peter once more,
"Surely you are one."
But he began to curse and to swear,
"I do not know this man about whom you are talking."
And immediately a cock crowed the second time. Then Peter remembered the word that Jesus had said to him, "Before the cock crows twice, you will deny me 3 times. He broke down and wept. As soon as morning came, the chief priests with the elders and the scribes, that is, the whole Sanhedrin, held council. They bound Jesus and led him away and handed him over to Pilate. Pilate questioned him,
"Are you the King of the Jews?"
He said to him in reply,
"You say so."
The chief priests accused him of many things. Again, Pilate questioned,
"Have you no answer? See how many things they accuse you of."
Jesus gave him no further answer, so that Pilate was amazed. Now, on the occasion of the feast, he used to release to them one prisoner whom they requested. A man called Barabbas was then in prison, along with the rebels who had committed murder in a rebellion. The crowd came forward and began to ask him to do for them as he was accustomed. Pilate answered,
"Do you want me to release to you the King of the Jews?"
For he knew it was out of envy that the chief priest had handed him over. But the chief priest stirred up the crowd to have him release Barabbas for them instead. Pilate said to them in reply,
"Then what do you want me to do with the man you call the King of the Jews?"
They shouted again,
"Crucify him."
Pilate said to them,
"Why? What evil has he done?"
They only shouted the louder,
"Crucify him."
So Pilate, wishing to satisfy the crowd, released Barabbas to them. After he had Jesus scourged, he handed him over to be crucified. The soldiers led him away inside the palace, that is, the praetorium, and assembled the whole cohort. They clothed him in purple and, weaving a crown of thorns, placed it on him. They began to salute him with,
"Hail, King of the Jews."
And they kept striking his head with a reed and spitting on him. They knelt before him in homage. And when they had mocked him, they stripped him of the purple cloak, dressed him in his own clothes, and led him out to crucify him. They pressed into service a passerby, Simon the Cyrenian, who was coming in from the country, the father of Alexander and Rufus, to carry his cross. They brought him to the place of Golgotha, which is translated place of the skull. They gave him wine drugged with myrrh, but he did not take it. When they crucified him, they divided his garments by casting lots for them to see what each should take. It was 9 o'clock in the morning when they crucified him. The inscription of the charge against him read, "The King of the Jews." With him, they crucified two revolutionaries, one on his right and one on his left. Those passing by reviled him, shaking their heads and saying,
"Aha, you who would destroy the temple and rebuild it in 3 days, save yourself by coming down from the cross."
Likewise, the chief priests with the scribes mocked him among themselves and said,
"He saved others, he cannot save himself. Let the Christ, the King of Israel, come down now from the cross, that we may see and believe."
Those who were crucified with him also kept abusing him. At noon, darkness came over the whole land until 3 p.m. And at 3 o'clock, Jesus cried out in a loud voice,
"Eloi, Eloi, lema sabachthani,"
which is translated,
my God, why have you forsaken me?"
Some of the bystanders who heard it said,
"Look, he is calling Elijah."
One of them soaked a sponge with wine and put it on a reed and gave it to him to drink, saying,
"Wait, let us see if Elijah comes down to take him down."
Jesus gave a loud cry and breathed his last. The veil of the sanctuary was torn in two from top to bottom. When the centurion who stood facing him saw how he had breathed his last, he said,
"Truly, this man was the Son of God."
There were also women looking on from a distance. Among them were Mary Magdalene, Mary the mother of the younger James and of Joses, and Salome. These women had followed him when he was in Galilee and ministered to him. There were also many other women who had come up with him to Jerusalem. When it was already evening, since the day of preparation, the day before the Sabbath, Joseph of Arimathea, a distinguished member of the council, who himself was awaiting the kingdom of God, came and courageously went to Pilate and asked for the body of Jesus. Pilate was amazed that he was already dead. He summoned the centurion and asked him if Jesus had already died. And when he learned of it from the centurion, he gave the body to Joseph. Having bought a linen cloth, he took him down and wrapped him in the linen cloth and laid him in a tomb that had been hewn out of rock. Then he rolled a stone against the entrance of the tomb. Mary Magdalene and the mother of Joses watched where he was laid. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord.
I believe
in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. The Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate, and suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and Son, who with the Father and Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets.
I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. And I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
We bring all our petitions before our Heavenly Father.
That church leaders may proclaim with courage and conviction the gospel of Christ crucified. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That world leaders may reflect the sovereignty of Christ as they work to eliminate unnecessary suffering from their countries. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the crucifixion of Christ for all people may teach us that there is no such thing as a worthless life or a person God does not love. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That all gathered here and our entire parish family may keep Holy Week well, and so be drawn more deeply into the saving mystery of Christ's death and resurrection. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those preparing to enter the church this Easter may be protected from evil, and grow in holiness. We pray to the Lord. That the sick and suffering, the elderly and infirm, will experience the healing touch of Christ. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who have died may find everlasting joy in the Father's kingdom, especially the deceased members of the Stevens family, as well as Linda Columbera Buffo. We pray to the Lord.
Heavenly Father, we ask you to hear and answer all our petitions, for they are offered through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Our offertory hymn is number 466, number 466.
Every tongue God bless him.
pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept this sacrifice at your hand, praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
O Lord, through the passion of your only begotten Son, may our reconciliation with you be near at hand, so that though we do not merit it by our own deeds, yet by this sacrifice made once for all, we may feel already the effects of your mercy, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For though innocent, he suffered willingly for sinners and accepted unjust condemnation to save the guilty. His death has washed away our sins, and his resurrection has purchased our justification. With all the angels we praise you, as in joyful celebration we acclaim. Of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world. Bring her to the fullness of charity together with Francis, our Pope, and Thomas, John, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit,
All glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Jesus taught us to call God our Father, and so we have the courage to pray. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come.
Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, from every evil. Grant peace in our days. By the help of your mercy, may we be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we wait the blessed hope in the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom and the power and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. Grant your peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit. Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Peace with you. Peace with you. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I'm not worthy that you should enter into my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
For those who cannot now receive Jesus in the Blessed Sacrament, we offer the following prayer. My Jesus, I believe that thou art present in the Blessed Sacrament. I love thee above all things, and I desire thee in my soul. Since I cannot now receive thee sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. As though thou wert already there, I embrace thee and unite myself wholly to thee. Permit me not that I should ever be separated from thee. Amen.
Thank you. Jesus.
Let us pray. O Lord, nourished with these sacred gifts, we humbly beseech you that just as through the death of your Son you have brought us to hope for what we believe, so by his resurrection may you lead us to where you call, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please join us tomorrow for our Palm Sunday penance service at 6:30 p.m. Going to confession is one of the best ways to prepare your soul to celebrate the Lord's resurrection, and there will be multiple priests from the area to hear confessions tomorrow evening. If you are an alum of St. Peter and Paul's school, don't forget that Monday is the cutoff date for RSVPs for our alumni reunion. We hope that you will join us for this fun evening. More information is in the bulletin. The parish office will be closed from Friday, March 29th, until Monday, April 1st for the Easter holiday, and the office will reopen on Tuesday, April 2nd. And finally, there is an error in the bulletin this weekend. There will not be morning Mass on Thursday or Friday this week. The Mass of the Lord's Supper on Thursday will be at 6:30 p.m., and the solemn liturgy for Good Friday will be at 3 p.m. The reflections on the seven last words of Christ will be at 6:30 p.m. on Friday, but this service does not include the adoration of the cross or the reception of Holy Communion. And finally, the Easter Vigil will be celebrated on Saturday at 7:30 p.m.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit. Bow down for the blessing.
O Lord, look on this your family, for whom our Lord Jesus Christ did not hesitate to be delivered into the hands of the wicked and submit to the agony of the cross, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.
Take up your cross, the